like energizes you, and then you walk into this. Before it was all compartmentalized, you wouldn't be able to see up these spiders. You could barely see up this spider.
And what you could see, you didn't want to see.
No, I mean, it was paneling and carpet and popcorn ceilings with a sparkle. We widened this area so much that this kitchen feels massive, but it's really functional and it's not taking over the room. We kept the house because that was the smart thing to do financially, but we needed to hide it. This is something they did in the mid-century design.
People can really customize the space however they want. They might have pictures of their dog in there, or they might have autographed football or something.
So glad you're not the one staying in this house. Love how it flows from here into the dining room. You have all of this seating along the island. You've taken the waterfall edge, and this is just really great space.
Sitting here with family, having a nice bite to eat, taking in mountain views, enjoying the pool.
I love this space. The fact that the bathroom has kind of a privatized toilet area, and then a floating vanity and a stunning wallpaper just gives it this glamour.
And then you've kind of tied it in a little bit with your fancy feature wall over here.
I know. And instead of entering into the bathroom here, now we actually have a salon addition to this master. This is such a fun bathroom. And this vanity goes in. This is an over an 8-foot span. The clear story windows up above just add this beautiful element architecturally and visually. I love that we've taken this dining chandelier and we've really kind of anchored it to this recently tub. It's stunning. Every part of the setting is like showstopper, showstopper, showstopper.
Well, the main house is off the chart. That guest house is just as good.
Let's go check it out. A difference in here. You wouldn't even be able to walk like this in here before. There was a peninsula blocking this kitchen. The kitchen was kind of the whole room. So making an L like this to really give it function and open up the space, it makes it be a studio apartment, and it's got a full access to kind of sort of like cool vibes. This is such a transformation out here.
We went from really the eyesore of the neighborhood and a junkyard in the backyard to like one of the most fun party houses.
You have a full-on dining, you've got a built-in fire pit, beautiful pool, gorgeous tile, massive spa, tanning shower. And we've really added these pavers just to lead us to this outdoor lounge area. We're mimicking a butterfly effect. Is it called butterfly effect? Is that a thing?
It's a different thing.
Come here, lazy girl. Lazy girl.
Love and be able to bring that into this without rebuilding it.
And
what's
this house
for? Let's see what the guys think. You ready? We purchased this home for $555,000 and spent another $510,000 on the renovation. Only $10,000 over budget, bringing us all in at $1,065,000.
After a few days on the market, we received an offer of $1.3 million. After $80,000 in closing costs, if this deal sticks, we'll make $155,000.